Ready?
Mizuno, the taller, rangier fighter, but look at the upper arms on Rafiq. This fight brought to you by Absolute Zero, Asia's first whole-body cryotherapy. Freeze, recover, train.
Rafiq's got that real barrel-chested type body that just looks like he just packs a mean punch.
Sure he does, yeah. Oh, and the right hand came in, sending Mizuno spinning round and into the cage. And he pressed up against it as he is now.
This is kind of how I thought the fight would go. Rafiq didn't want to stay on the outside with Mizuno being taller and bigger and a little bit longer. So looking for Rafiq to try and get the fight to the ground, try and nullify the length and the reach.
Yeah, Rafiq, I think, looking to swing him round.
Nice, nice. Mizuno hitting the Kimura, rolling him through, trying to get on top now. There you go. See him switching his hips, get right on top. He's got that Kimura grip to try and break it away from his lower abdomen there. He's going to try and lift it up and put it behind his back.
Is this where those strong arms of Rafiq come into play?
Yeah, Rafiq's really looking like he's sitting up with him, which is pretty impressive. Mizuno needs to keep that chest down on him, keep that pressure down on him. Looks like he's, oh, right to the transition on the arm. Oh, he lost it. I'm actually kind of surprised he went for that position. Mizuno fighting the hands. They're just right here in front of us, cage side.
Right up above us. Olivier Coste telling Mizuno not to grab the fence. You can touch it, you can push off it, but you can't clasp it, which is he's doing there, and he gets reprimanded for it.
Mizuno's making space for that Kimura again. I noticed that Mizuno was able to stop that takedown by grabbing the fence. That's probably something we want to go to Rich for on that, you know, what type of rules regulation that was.
Yeah, there are rules regulations on grabbing the fence, both with your hands and actually weaving your toes into the fence. It didn't stop the takedown, and, you know, he just got warned for that, but that's something that if you are able to reverse position or stop the position, it can make a big difference in the fight.
He did kind of end up on top a little bit, though. Should the ref have maybe possibly stopped and stood him back up?
I think in this particular case, it was kind of a no harm, no foul type of thing. They're back to their feet again working, so.
Right, yeah. Back in the same position.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's a big temptation for fighters. You see them do it a lot. And again, he's been warned there by Olivier Coste, the referee. And again, and if he keeps doing it, a yellow card might come out of the top pocket.
Rafiq's really trying to keep him pressed against the fence, trying to make sure that he doesn't have any space to work.
Action.
That taller, longer body is sometimes harder to work when you're against the fence. It's a little bit easier to stop the takedowns because you have a wider base. You can actually use the fence to your advantage in stopping the takedown.
Our referees here tonight love to see action. They don't like to see a lull in that action, and that's why Olivier Coste sent the fighters to the center of the cage so they could get it on again. Or left hand, clipping left hand from Rafiq. Just brushed Mizuno's.
Mizuno just looks like a way bigger person in the cage. When you see them standing next to each other, you can just tell the difference. Rafiq, though, just like I said, barrel-chested, really pushing the pace, trying to keep him pressed against the fence.
Strong legs to do that as well. And again, Olivier Coste calls it a stalemate and brings them to the center.
What's going to be interesting to see how long Rafiq could keep this pace, though, on trying to keep him pressed against the fence. You know, he's going to be, it looks like he's bearing quite a bit of Mizuno's weight when he's against the fence there. Mizuno looks really relaxed. Like I said, he's been in the cage with top guys from all around the world. Mirko Krokop being one of them. I mean, learning how to take, you know, big shots from them. Nothing he hasn't seen in that cage, I don't think, being against those type of guys.
Subtle movements from Mizuno's head just allows him to evade those punches. Three of them, one coming after the other. Did so well to just drop out of range. And that'll be tiring for Rafiq to throw those bombs and not land.
You can already see Rafiq's kind of staying on the outside now. He's either all the way outside of the striking range, or he's all the way in trying to press him against the fence.
Oh, Rafiq just giving him, blowing him a little kiss as Mizuno missed with a clubbing kick.
Rafiq closing that distance again, keeping him pressed against the fence. Keeps trying to work that little step behind trip.
Final half minute of the first round.
Drop down on that single leg, see if he dips his head out, hits a dump. He's going to dump him on that single leg, try to dump him to his butt. There he goes.
There it is.
But Mizuno with that Kimura grip again, trying to roll him through. He's going to look to come back up on top, get his hips over the top. There he goes. He's sitting up into him. Some light strikes. Still has that Kimura grip.
It's again.
There you go. Rafiq's looking to roll him through. Break. Good round.
This one will go into the second.
Fight!
So everything to fight for in round two. And just a reminder, judges will score this fight based on the entire contest, not round by round. Good right hand from Brayan Rafiq. And Mizuno turns his back as a result. Olivier Coste making sure that there's no grasping of that fence. Elbow from Mizuno.
There he goes again for that Kimura grip because he knows that Rafiq's trying to get the takedown. He's going to keep trying to roll him through. There he goes again. Now he looks like he's going to try and make a transition to some sort of leg lock.
See working if he can. On that ankle, isn't he? Twisting it round.
Seems to be looking to start looking for a knee bar. Nice little kicks to the head there.
Using his heel to just hit the head and the toe. Coming from Rafiq.
If he can get his hips lower than his knee, then he can work on that knee bar, which it looks like he's trying to do. He's going to try and pull Rafiq's ankle up towards his ears. There he goes. He's trying to slide his hips down. There it is. There's that knee bar.
Scrambling around the two of them.
He's still trying to work it. He's on top. It's the perfect position to finish that knee bar position. Also, he's able to reach back and elbow the head, throw some punches. He really likes that Kimura, as you see. He's going for it again. He looks like he's let go of the leg.
Action! Let's work to finish.
He's working on that grip. He's just, he's let it go.
Club to the back of the head. The back of the head is an illegal punch, but it's so difficult to see exactly where you're landing sometimes. Mizuno wasn't really looking at the head. It was in his peripheral vision. I don't think anything intentional there.
Now he's kind of in a half butterfly guard. Mizuno is pushing on the face of Rafiq. This is where Rafiq doesn't want to be, where he's bearing the weight of Mizuno, who's obviously the bigger fighter.
Rafiq's head exposed to a possible left knee there from Mizuno, but he's tucked it in, so he's not going to try that.
Rafiq's going to need to start to dig that left side underhook and scoot his hips out to avoid any damage to the face. You see Mizuno pushing on the face, looking to set up an elbow.
They're not 5 feet away from us here at cage side.
He's got to press against the fence. Rafiq needs to start looking to maybe put his back to the fence. Try and wall walk. We call it wall walking, where you use your back against the fence and walk your way all the way up. Get back to your feet. He does not want to be here. This is the one position he doesn't want to be, being the smaller fighter. He does not want to be in this position.
Olivier Coste wants to see action from Mizuno. Doesn't want to just have him lie there and generate another stalemate. He wants to see entertainment and action for this crowd. Ground and pound, a brief flurry, and again, up kicks from Rafiq.
Swinging for that arm. It's gonna be real hard to get that arm bar now that they're sweaty. You know, we're halfway through the second round.
Yeah, the ability to grip diminishes the sweatier your opponent gets.
Rafiq needs to look to probably grab wrist control, start putting his back against that fence and start trying to wall walk up it.
Action!
You're not gonna win the round sitting here with a bigger guy laying on top of you.
It's work.
Mizuno sending in that right hand, 6-7 of them. He has to do that to keep Olivier Coste happy, because he's watching and he wants action.
Mizuno really laying down the punches right now, controlling everything, hipping in, looking to start doing some ground and pound.
Oh, that came from a long way up.
Rafiq looking to hit that knee bar, transition. He needs to kick away and get up here. This is where he can't afford to sit there on his back.
Mizuno didn't really give him an opportunity. Was all over him there, cutting off the angles, anticipating his spins.
Mizuno's going to try and push that head down between his legs so he can start looking to work a Darce choke. There he goes. Mizuno kicks up.
Again, he couldn't quite get up. Or either that, or was just content to hold on his back. Half a minute left in this round, but no. Predictably, Olivier Coste has seen enough of that position. And up they come to the applause of the crowd here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium.
Mizuno looking to push the pace.
Big right hand from Rafiq. He follows up with a couple of swinging left and lets Mizuno off the hook in the dying seconds. You wonder if he hadn't followed up there, he could have perhaps done a little bit more damage as that second round came to a close.
You feel like Rafiq can still win this fight?
Oh, absolutely. Listen, we judge based on being able to finish the fight. And, you know, you land some big damage or something in the third round, and that can be, especially based on the criteria, a near finish will outscore a little bit of ground control through the entire fight.
Rafiq's throwing big punches right now, and they're landing, and they're hitting Mizuno right on the chin.
This fight is there for Rafiq to take if he wants it. He's got every opportunity to do something special in this fight, even though Mizuno has probably had the edge. That's the way the fights are scored here. And it provides for much more entertainment than your standard 10-point must system. It's Mizuno doing the poaching at the moment, stalking the fighter.
This is the third round, so we really want to see if the weight made a difference in that second round with Mizuno laying on top of Rafiq, throwing big punches.
They exchange good knees to the midriff. Rafiq thinks that Mizuno's blow was low. Mizuno doesn't agree, and I must say, on first look, I'm not convinced either.
Mizuno, ready? Brayan, fight!
Rafiq comes straight back out, so didn't seem that interested in taking too much of a rest. But he may have got let off a little bit lightly there, because I don't think that was low.
Mizuno keeping him on the outside of his punches. Every time Rafiq jumps in, beautiful
knee
Mizuno.
To the head, Mizuno. Rafiq is looking a little bit tired, isn't he?
Yes, he is. See him backing away with his hands down. It's never a good sign. Mizuno really needs to just get in his face, keep his hands up, press him against the fence, and start laying in with those big knees.
There's a long way to go in this final round as well. Is Tatsuya Mizuno coming to the fore? We think he's got the edge in the fight anyway, but this could be where he really brings it home. The heavily muscled Rafiq looks to be tiring slightly.
Probably be smart for Mizuno to try and get a takedown, maybe push him against the fence, start posturing up and giving big punches.
And this practice of breaking the fighters if there's not much action is really in Mizuno's favor, because Rafiq looks like he wants as much rest as he can get in the clinches.
I was just thinking the same thing. Mizuno just needs to keep walking him down, putting pressure on him, making him react. He's giving him, if you notice right here, he's trying to give him a second to settle in, kind of get his breath. He needs to start pushing the pace, get into his grill.
As Rafiq comes in, Mizuno is timing those right hands very sweetly indeed. Good right hand from Rafiq though.
Let's go, fight!
Still stalking the Japanese man, isn't he? He's the one coming forward. That might account in the aggression stakes, which doesn't count for an awful lot in terms of what the judges look at. But it does count for something.
There's nothing I don't think that Rafiq can do that Mizuno hasn't already seen. Being in the ring with guys like Mirko Krokop, Gegard Mousasi, those type of guys. There's nothing that Rafiq's going to deliver.
Oh, good right hand from Rafiq. Sent Mizuno back, but he pushes his arms aside and says, well, that didn't hurt. Give me another one if you can. Forward comes Mizuno again. Good right hand from Rafiq. They're exchanging good punches in this round. Single shots, but they're heavy.
Nice kick. Beautiful low kick.
Rafiq's chance, Josh, could come if he can just throw a combination together rather than single punches.
Brayan, more action.
Again, that's a stern warning. He wants more action with a minute and a quarter left. Brayan Rafiq is tired. More action is the last thing on his mind, I should think.
Mizuno just needs to pull the trigger a little bit more and let his hands and kicks go. Those kicks are dangerous. You heard the last one land. It was pretty loud. I can hear it all the way across the cage. Beautiful.
Oh, he really threw that right hand with bad intention. It was well off, though, Rafiq.
Rafiq's still showing that he's dangerous, though, with those big hands.
And one of those could end the fight. 40 yes. seconds left. Another right hand there. Didn't have everything that he threw just previously. And Mizuno looks to be working towards a narrow judge's decision.
I saw Mizuno take a look up at the clock, see how much time was left, see if he really pushes the pace this last 30 seconds.
It was a nice left hand from Rafiq, and he tried it again. But with 20 seconds left, Mizuno looks like he might have done enough. Good left hand from the Japanese. As soon as this is done, we'll go to Rich Franklin and get his thoughts on where the decision should go. Attempted takedown didn't work out. As Rafiq presses Mizuno up against the cage, the bell has gone for the end of the fight.
For your winner, via unanimous decision, from the blue corner, Tatsuya Mizuno!
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.